Blackstone Publishing presents From the Grave by David Housewright. This book is read by Brent Hinkley. For Renee Marie Valois. 1. The young woman who identified herself as a psychic medium moved with almost absent-minded confidence among the 50 people who had paid $40 each for a seat in the community center lecture hall, with the hope that she might help them connect with a dead mother or father, uncle or aunt, a dead child, but no promises. She was tall and slender with shoulder-length hair, high cheekbones and amber-tinted eyes. If you met her at a party or in a club, you would say, "You should be a model." Both beautiful and dashing. Even her name had a kind of au courant vibe. Hannah Broughton. At least that's what Shelby Dunston was thinking when the woman slowly strolled up the aisle toward where she was sitting. Shelby braced herself. She had come with the hope of connecting with her grandfather, but now she wasn't sure if she wanted to. What would he tell her after all these years? "Sorry I died on your 16th birthday? Sorry that now, whenever June 11th rolls around, your mother and father and aunts and uncles and cousins get sad and mournful?" Hannah halted two rows from where Shelby was sitting, looked directly into her eyes, and smiled. "Okay, this is why I came," Shelby told herself. Only Hannah turned her head and looked off toward the people sitting on her left. "There's someone stepping forward," Hannah said. "A woman. Oh, this one is a talker. She's talking 100 words a minute. Yes, I hear you. Yes, please slow down. Okay, okay." Hannah glanced to her right and then to her left. "Alice?" Hannah asked. No one responded. "I'm sorry," Hannah said. "Allison." A woman in her early 60s, Shelby decided, was sitting half a row away. She cautiously raised her hand. "The woman who came forward, she's your mother," Hannah said. The older woman shook her head as if she didn't want to believe it.
"People called her Chrissy," Hannah said.
But it wasn't short for Christine or Christina. Her real name was Chrysanthemum. The woman clasped her hand over her mouth. Tears appeared in her eyes as if someone had turned on a faucet. Hannah clutched the right side of her chest. "Okay, I feel that," she said. "Chrissy, I feel that. Allison, your mother died of lung cancer, didn't she?" Allison nodded, her hand still covering her mouth. "She wants you to know. Your mother wants you to know that she's sorry. She used to always have a cigarette in her hand. She used to wave it around when she talked, and she talked a lot, didn't she?" Allison nodded some more. "Chrissy says she never went more than 5 minutes without a cigarette. She's making me smell it." "Come on, Chrissy, don't do that." "She says she's sorry. She said that everyone smoked back then and that she didn't know any better. She's sorry that she left you and your sister so young. She says, Chrissy, wait, too fast. She says you have to stop blaming yourself. She says, Allison, did you win a writing contest with an essay on the dangers of cigarette smoking?" Allison nodded her head. She removed her hand from her mouth and spoke softly. Shelby could barely hear her. "In the 8th grade, Allison said, the winners read their essays live on WCCO radio. Chrissy wants you to know that she was very proud of you, not only for the essay but for the woman you've become," Hannah said. "She wants you to know that you can't blame yourself for not trying harder to make your mother quit smoking and that she's sorry she didn't pay closer attention to your essay. But you have to remember that she was the parent and you were the child. She was responsible for you, but you weren't responsible for her. You would tell her, 'Don't smoke anymore, Mama,' and she'd say, 'Yeah, yeah,' and keep doing it anyway. That's her mistake, not yours. She says, 'Oh, you have a daughter that's named after a flower, too. Poppy. You named your daughter Poppy.'" Allison nodded her head vigorously. "Chrissy said that the poppy was her favorite flower." "I know," Allison said. "That's why you named her Poppy." Allison nodded again. "Chrissy says thank you. And she says, wait. Okay."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.